Good morning, all of you. So as we know, till last class, we have been studied three laws. That is what we should call it as Kepler's laws of planetary motion. So we have been discussed the first Kepler's laws of planetary motion. Also, we can call it as what, guys? Law of orbits. Next,
orbit.
The second Kepler's laws of planetary motion is also called as
law
of areas. So, and third Kepler's third law of planetary motion is called as law of periods. So,
yes.
All the things we have been discussed, and even we know the formula of Kepler's third law of planetary motion also. So, everything you already studied, and we have been solved even numerical also. So, the Kepler's third law, what is indicating? T1 square, if you consider two planets, they are revolving. If the period of revolution of two planets, if you consider T1 and T2, and their average radius of their orbit is R1 and R2. So,
R1 and
yes, we know the relation. What is the relation, guys? So, by the time T1 square divided by R1 cube, which is equal to T2 square divided by R2 cube. So this is what the relation we have been done in the last class. This is only called as Kepler's third law of planetary motion. So if you consider single planet, what we can say, the square of the time period is directly proportional to what it is, the average
of the mean
planet of the ellipse, cube of the average radius of the planet of the ellipse. Yes or no? Planet's ellipse. That is what we can say. Kepler's third law. Are you understand, guys? So now, with the help of this, now we are going to study, in our today's class, we are going to study Newton's law of gravitation. So usually, our textbook, we will study first Newton's law of gravitation. Or else also, we can call it as what, guys? Universal law of gravitation, also known as universal law of gravitation. But actually, Newton has been done with the help of Kepler. So that is why first we have to know what is Kepler's laws of planetary motion. That is why we have been studying what is Kepler's laws of planetary motion. So now we are going to study the next one called as what, guys? Newton's law of gravitation. So also we can call it as what, Ra? Law of universal gravitation. What
do you call? Universal law.
Universal. Law of universal. Understand? Gravitation. So also we can call
gravitation.
It Newton's law of universal gravitation. So anything you can call it. Newton's law of universal gravitation. So some interesting things also I will say. So if you'll observe, usually here, Kepler has been given three laws regarding the motion of the planets. That is what we have been studied, Kepler's laws of planetary motion. So now here, if you see, in 1666, 45 years after Kepler's published his work, and Newton began his studies of planetary motion. Means Kepler has been published his work 45 years before. Later only, in which era? In 1665. Means 1666, not 5. So means 45 years before itself, Kepler has been published these three laws. Later only, Newton has started or begun his studies of planetary motion. And he found that the magnitude of force, that is what we should call it as gravitational force. Understand, the magnitude of force F on a planet due to the sun is varies inversely with the square of the distance R between the centers of the planets and the sun. So that is what he has been found. So with the help of experiment, we are going to calculate now. So what he has been said means, so try to understand carefully. So let us consider two planets or else two bodies. So that bodies are M1 and M2. What we should call that bodies? So what he has been said means, so the force acting between two bodies. So here we are considering as sun and the planet. What we are considering, guys? One is sun, another one is what? Planet.
Sun and the planet.
So now he is considering two bodies. What is that body? This is body one, M1 mass, and this is the another body. What is that body mass? M2. Is it okay, guys? M2. Do you understand? So the masses are M1 and M2, and the distance between their centers. What we can assume, Pradosh? The distance between the centers, assume as
R.
The distance between
R.
Bodies, and R is the distance between from the centers. From where? From the center. So the distance between the between their centers is, let us consider R. So this is what the things you have to note it down. So one is what? The mass of the bodies is M1 and the mass of the body 2 is M2. And the distance between their centers is what? R. What is that, guys? R. So this is what we have to assume for the universal law of gravitation, or else we can say what? Newton's law of gravitation. So here, what Newton said means, you can consider sun and the any planet. That is also, it is correct only. So here, you can see here, what has been said means, first thing, the force acting between these two bodies. The force acting between these two bodies. That is what? What is that force we can say, guys? The gravitational force of attraction. What is that called as? The
gravitational force of attraction.
Everybody should call the gravitational force of attraction between any two bodies. Between any two bodies.
Any two bodies
in this universe. In this universe is directly proportional to the product of their masses. What is that? It is directly proportional to the product of their masses. What is that? What is this called as? Universe. What is this F indicates, guys? What is this F indicates,
force.
Guys?
Force of gravitation.
Force of attraction. What we should call?
Gravitational force of attraction.
Yes. Gravitational force of attraction. Gravitational force of attraction. If you have doubt, you can ask me. Gravitational force of attraction is directly proportional to, what is the symbol for this, Ra? This symbol is indicating directly proportional. So force is directly proportional to product of their masses, means M1 into M2. This is what the first statement. So this is given by Newton. So Newton said that what? So if you consider any two bodies in this universe, so the force of attraction, the gravitational force of attraction between any two bodies in the universe is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between their centers. What is that? Inversely proportional to the square of the distance between from their centers. Distance between from their centers. What we should call as universal law of gravitation, or we can say Newton's law of gravitation. So what he said, Jayavarshini? He has been said that, Sai. So the gravitational force of attraction is directly proportional to product of their masses, or we can say, and
inversely proportional to
square of the distance between their centers. Do you understand? So that is what you have to remember. So now, this is only, this F is inversely proportional to F is inversely proportional to square of center distance between them. This is only called as inverse square law. What we should call? Inverse square rule. So we will study that again. Already I have taught you long back, but again I will teach you. So let me imagine this is equation 1 and this is equation 2, if you'll assume. Now don't resolve, but listen first. So later only you can say. So this F is, So the force of attraction is inversely proportional to square of distance between their centers, distance between from the center. This is only what you should call, Prados, inverse square law. All of you should remember.
Inverse square law
we used to call it as. So now if we'll combine these two, what we can get if we'll combine these two equations, what we used to get? So we can say
is equal to m1 into m2
to product of masses
divided by square
distance between them. So now, as we know in mathematics, if you want to remove this proportionality, we have to bring
it.
Constant, sir.
Yes or no, guys? Sai?
Sir.
So we have to bring some constant. So that is only. So if we'll bring that constant, what do you assume right here? That the constant is called as
G, sir.
So capital G into M1 into M2. Divided
by R square.
What you have to remember. So this is only called as formula for what? Universal law of gravitation. Or we can say it is Newton's law of gravitation. Understand? Universal law of gravitation. Or we can say Newton's law of gravitation. So now the G is called as what, guys? G is the constant of
gravitational constant.
Understanding, it is a constant of proportionality, that is only known as universal gravitational constant. What we should call
universal gravitational constant.
Okay, so G is the constant of proportionality. Proportionality. Do you understand the meaning of that? We are removing proportionality sign. That is why it is called as constant of proportionality. So that is only called as what? What we should call? Called gravitational constant. Gravitational constant. So this is called as that is. So now, this is the formula for what? Law of gravitation,
universal law of gravitation.
F indicate what, guys? F indicate the
gravitational force of attraction.
Between any two bodies. Understand? So now, if you'll go to your textbook, then they will be maybe modified as a like this. Then you no need to worry about it. So they have been considered two bodies, and the distance between them, between their centers, is considered as D. What they have been considered? D, distance. Understand, Ra? So now D. Most of the standard textbooks they will follow are, okay, our textbook is following D. So that is also correct only. And mass of the body 1 is M, and the mass of the body 2 is small m, capital M and small m.
Small m.
Then according to this, what is the formula will come? F is directly proportional to L, okay? Capital M into
small m
divided by d square.
Nothing will change. So now this one, if you'll write it, proportionality will remove equals to side. Then
capital G
equal to
M into small m to capital M divided by d square.
So no confusion. Adarshan, Sai, understand, Sai? Everybody, Laksha, Alana. So both are same. There is no confusion between them. Both are same, equal. So which is convenient for you, you can do it. You can follow it. There is nothing in wrong. But you have to mention while you are writing. R indicate what? R indicate the distance between the centers. Understand? Any bodies. R, D indicates also same thing. So that is only called as universal law of gravitation, or we can say Newton's law of gravitation. So please, all of you keep reading. Newton's law of gravitation. So now, one more thing I want to say here. Now, if body 1 is acting force on body 2, then whose change will takes place? That is already we have been studied long back. So if body 1 is acting force on body 2, then whose acceleration will change? Means who in which body we can change the
body 2, sir.
Body 2. Next, if body 2 is acting on body 1, then what is happening? then
41.
That is what you can remember. F12, F21. That is also most important. So you can observe, notice here. So this body is acting force on this body. Then we can say this is F12. What we can say? F12. This is, we can say what? F21. Understand? Yes. Always remember, first digit is indicating the force exerted by every body. Second body is indicating on which it is acting. Do you understand, Elamukil? Others and everybody?
Yes, sir.
Also, you have to remember. So, this is the diagram you have to draw very neatly. So, you have to take two bodies, M1 and M2, and you have to start writing. First, take Newton's law of gravitation. You keep heading. Newton's law of gravitation. Or also we can call it as what?
Universal law of gravitation.
You can say universal law of gravitation, or we can say gravitational force, or that universal law of gravitation. Anything you can write. So usually what Newton said, actually, it is not between any two bodies. He said between sun and the planet. What he said? Between the sun and the planet. Consider it is applicable for throughout the universe. That is why we will consider any two bodies. Do you understand, Ra? Any two bodies who is to be going to take it. That is what you can take. Even he found that even apples and moons also acceleration agreed with the 1/r² relationship. So that is why. Okay, Ra? So everything, it has been applicable. Not first he has been said for sun and the planet. Sun and the planet. But later, he has been also find that also moon and the apple, because he is famous for Newton's third law. What is Newton's third law, Monish? What is Newton's third law?
Minus reaction.
So he has been found that also. So that is why the force exerted on the earth on the apple and earth on the moon and the apple on the moon are same way. Apple on the earth, always everything is same as the force of the apple exerted on the same on the earth. But that is why. So the force of attraction between two bodies must be proportional to the object masses, and that is only we should call as gravitational force. What we should call, guys? Gravitational force. So this has been applicable. First, he has been said for planets and the sun. Later, it has been found that for every bodies in the universe is same. So that is why it is called as universal law of universal gravitation. What we should call? Law of universal gravitation. So what is that indicating, Ra? F is equals to capital G into M1 into M2 divided by R². Do you understand, guys? Please respond.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
So, that is what we used to call it as. So first, all of you keep heading. Newton's law of gravitation. Also, we can call it as what, Ra? Universal law of gravitation. Universal law of gravitation. So please write it. First statement. The gravitational force of attraction. Darun, are you understand, Darun? What is the universal law of gravitation? Jayavarshini, Laksha?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So please write. The gravitational force of attraction between any two bodies in the universe is directly proportional to the product of their masses product of their masses and is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between their centers. So now, what you have to do, Ra, now? You have to draw the mathematics expressions. First, draw the diagram. Which diagram you will draw? This diagram with the help of scale and everything. You have to draw this. So, this is the one body and this is the another body. So, you have to draw straight line from their centers. So, centers, if you want, you can draw a small dot also like this you can keep. So, distance between the centers. So, now this is M1 and this is M2. So, the distance between the centers, what we should assume, Ra? R. Okay. So, now force acting by body 1 on body 2, F12. Force acting by body 2 on body 1, F21. So, now what is the mathematical expression, Pradosh? F is directly proportional to M1 into
M2. M1 into M2 divided.
Directly proportional, sorry, inversely proportional to square of the distance between the distance. So, write this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. So, F indicates what are here? F indicates what?
Gravitational
force of attraction with two bodies.
Gravitational force of attraction, and you can write M1 and M2 are masses of the bodies. R indicate what are? Distance between their centers. Yes, distance between the centers of the bodies. Centers of the bodies, you can say. So now this F is inversely proportional to F is inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. This is only called as what we should call, Jayavarshini, Shruti. This is only called the as
universal law of gravitation.
Inverse square law. I am asking only F is inversely proportional to square of the distance.
Inverse square.
That is only called as inverse square law. So please all of you write it. That is. So next point. Combine 1 and 2. What we should get, Ra? Combining equations 1 and 2. What we should get?
F is directly proportional to M1 into M2 divided by.
Combining equation 1 and 2. We used to get what? F is directly proportional to M1 and M1 into M2 divided by
R square.
Okay. So now, as we know, if you want to remove this proportionality, we have to take some constant. That is what we are taking. So F is equals to a constant called as what? G. Capital G.
Capital G.
M1 into M2 divided by R square. So this G is only called as what? Gravitational constant. That is what we should call as the formula for universal law of gravitation. What is this called as? Universal law of gravitation. Now, below this, according to a textbook also, simply draw one more diagram and you have to assume the distance between them. What are you looking here? The distance between their bodies is D. Understand? Centers D. Sai, are you understand, Sai, this one? D. So you can write this point also. Just do it fast. This is for our convenience. Again, you are not supposed to face any problem. Laksha, are you understand, Laksha? Alana, please respond me, Alana. Maitreyan, Adarshan, that is. Clear, guys?
Yes, sir, understood.
Yes. So now, we will go with a little bit. So now you can see this F is inversely proportional to something. Can you say what is that? F is inversely proportional to something. What is that, guys?
Sir, R.
1 by R square.
Yes. So that is. So now, as we know here, so F is directly proportional to product of their masses, M1 and M2. So we can say if the planet near the sun, were doubled, the force of attraction would also be doubled. So that is what you have to remember it. So that is the meaning of product. Force of attraction is directly proportional to the product of their masses. So now you can see, I will connect even mass to physics here, and you can notice it, how this mass to physics and what is the relation will take place. So if mass will become double, Pradosh, can you able to notice it, Pradosh? If, suppose, let me imagine this is the sun. If this is the sun, now, if we'll take the planet which is close to the sun, if the mass will become double, then the force increases how many times, Ra? Force directly proportional.
Two times.
The force if directly proportional to m1.
Directly proportional to.
So now if mass will become double, then what will happen? Force also will become.
Force is also double.
Force
double.
Also will become double. That is what you have to remember. So if change mass, mass will become double, then force also will increase. How many times, Ra? Force also will increase. Double. Double. That is what you have to remember. But if you'll take now, suppose if radius will become r, radius will become 2r, r will become 2r, then what will happen, Elmukil? R will become 2r. Okay. So 1 by r square, correct? So 1 by r square, we can say now r will become what?
Is directly proportional to 1 by 4f.
Yeah, you can see here. So in place of r, we can write what? 2r.
2r square.
So 1 by 4r square. So how many times it is decreases?
1 by 4.
1 by 4 times it is decreases. 1 by 4. You understand everybody? 1 by 4 times it is decreases. Are you understand or not? Please respond me. That is what. So
sir.
We have understanding direct and inverse relationships between Newton's law of universal gravitation. So both direct and inverse relations we have. So that is why now I will show you the two diagrams. So two tabular columns. So please all of you note down that. So how we are connecting mass to physics. So this is the importance. This is what we should call as integration. So integrating mass with the physics, physics with the mass. So here you can see the tabular column. So here notice it. This tabular column is most important. So how we are connecting mass to physics, you can see here. So here notice it, all of you. Jayavarshini, can you able to see this one? So now mass become double. What will become, Ra? See, mass will become double. Then what is happening? Resultant.
Force became double.
Force become double. Double.
Now you can see distance between the centers become double. Then Sai, what is happening, Sai? Resultant force is decreasing. How many times? 1 by 4 times. Next, mass become triple. What is happening, guys? Force become triple. And radius, the distance between them is become increases 3 times. So the force is decreases how many times, Ra? Force is
by nine times.
Sir, how, sir? You can see. So because we know 1 by r square. Now r become what, Ra? R will become what? 3r whole square. People will forget to do the square this one. So it will become what, guys? 1 by 9 r square.
1 by
9 f. So it will decrease
as 9f.
By 9 times. Next. Now you can see here. If mass will become, one body mass will become double. And another body mass will become triple. So two bodies. So what will become the total force? 2 into 3. It will become what? 6 times. Understand, Ra? So force increases 6 times. Understand, Ra? First body mass is increases double. Second body mass is increases triple. This is a new point. Be very careful. Second body mass is increases triple. Then the force increases how many times, Ra? 3 twos are how much? 3 twos are?
6 times.
Understanding. So, this is what the force. Now see, R become what, Ra? R by 2. R become R by 2. Means it will become half. Yes or no, Ra? Half it is.
That's right.
Half means what will come, Pradosh? You can see, Adarshan. So, 1 by R square. Now, we are making what? 1 by
4.
R by 2. A whole square. So, which will become?
Square.
1 by r by 4. So as we know,
4 by r square.
So again, division
four
is
4 by r square.
Will become what? 4 by r square. So it is
increases 4 by r square.
It is increases how many times? 4 into 1 by r square.
Into r square.
So it is increases 4 times. Is it yes or no, guys? Same way.
Yes, sir.
No. Mass become half. Mass become half. Then force also will become what, Ra? It is directly proportional. So directly proportional, what will become, guys?
If mass sir.
Force also will become half. Do you understand, everyone? Please respond.
Yes, sir.
That
yes, sir.
Now radius becomes, so the distance between the centers is decreases by 1 by 3 times. Then what will happen, Ra? 1 by 3. Understanding means in the sense of what? R by 3 whole square. Correct, Ra? So 1 by r square divided by 3 square means 9. So it will become what? 9 into 1 by r square. So it is increases how many times, Ra? Increases how many
times?
9 times. 9
times
it increases. Do you have you understand this tabular column, everybody? Any doubt you can ask me. Tamil Selvan? Yes or no? So this is what the formula. So universal law of gravitation is directly proportional to product of their masses and inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. This is what we should call it as Newton's law of gravitation or universal law of gravitation. Any doubt you can ask me. So this tabular column will help you for MCQs and even in question numericals also. So while you are solving the numericals, you can understand. Sir, you could not understand 4F alone. Okay, Laksha. Now 4F alone you can see. Now it will become, what is the formula? You can check it, Laksha. So let me imagine this is the case one. So this is the case one, Laksha. Now R will become, second case, R will become what, guys? F into M1 into M2 divided by radius become 1 by 2. Is it SR, no, Elmokel? 1 by 2 whole square.
SR.
Now F is equals to G into M1 into M2 divided by, this is how I can write, guys. This is how I can write.
By 4.
Square divided by 2
square by 4.
Is it okay, Laksha? Now F is equals to J version, you understand? M1 into M2 divided by R square divided by 4. Now you can see D is again having division. So then what is the formula, Pradosh? How it will turn?
F is equal to G into M1 into M2 into 4.
Sorry, F is equal to G into M1 into M2 into 4.
Can I write it as a, like this? 4 into M1 into M2 divided by... Yes, sir. No?
Yes, sir.
This is all equals to what? Let me imagine this is F2. F2 because new second force, correct it is. So now, this is all equals to what, guys? Force. Yes, sir. No? F1. So now, F2 is equals...
Yes, sir.
F2 is equals to 4F. Can I write it or not?
4F.
In place of F. Yes, sir. No, Laksha. Now you understand or not? Shruti, please respond me. Sai, that is how it will come. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? Adarshan? That is. So please take this one, yes, and solve it. Everybody. If you are clear only, then we can proceed further. Darun, are you understand, Darun, this one? Alana?
Yes, sir.
It's okay. Please take this tabular column. Now I will show you the graph also. So now, take this. Have you taken this tabular column? Elmokel, this tabular column will be helpful in numericals, most probably solving. So they will give you in question, body mass is decreases 2 times. Body mass is increases 5 times. Then you have to take it like this. According to that, you have to consider the values in R values, the mass values in a question, numerical value are solving. You understand? They will ask you basically, this is the force. Now mass of the bodies are increases double. Then what is the resultant force? They will ask you, calculate the resultant force. Then by the time you have to solve like this step wise. Is it okay, Pradosh? Is it clear? Yes. Nobody.
Yes, sir.
That is.
Yes, sir.
Graph also I will show you. That is most important because graph you must know. They will give you the graph. So now force versus distance, how this graph will changes. The change in gravitational force with the distance follows what? Inverse square law. That is what we have been studying. The distance is increases, force is decreasing. Correct? The force is the distance is decreasing, force is increasing. Correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, that is why that graph also you should know. Now, how it is? What is the unit of force? Anybody, guys? What is the unit of force? Respond me.
Newtons.
Newtons. Yes or no? And the distance is what? Distance is what? Meters. Correct, meters. Sir? Now, you can consider this diagram. You can see this graph. If you plot the graph, force versus distance. Understand? So, now you can see. Always force will follow what? Force will follow inverse square law. Force will follow what? Force will follow inverse square law. So it is depend on the amount of force. The amount of gravitational force is purely depend on inverse square law only. That is what? The distance between the centers. So you can see the graph will be like this. Understand? So distance is keep on increasing. You can see here. Then the forces keep on decreasing. Have you noticed it, guys? Please respond. When the distance is very small, the force is maximum. The force is maximum. When the distance is maximum, then the force is what? Force is what? Minimum. That is what you have to understand. Hope you all understand. Yes or no, this one. Please respond me. So this is what you have
yes,
to.
Sir. Yes, sir.
So you will see this one. Understand, guys? So how it is affecting one another? If you connect this mass to physics feature, so you can see changing one variable affect another. So you can see the inverse square law graphically. So then what is happening right here? The distance is keep on increasing between the two bodies so that forces keep on decreasing. You may notice it. Yes or no? So now you can see after certain distance, the force will become negligible. Have you noticed it, guys? Almost it is zero. Have you noticed it? It is negligible force. So that is why the bodies are not attracting each other. Why the one body is not falling another body towards to each other? Because even though the force is acting between them, but still what is happening, Ra? Elamukil, the distance between them is much more. That is why they are not falling each other towards to each other. Do you understand? That is what you have to understand it. So this is the graph for what? Force versus distance, inverse square law. That is what you have to remember it. Hope you all understand this one. Is there any doubt? You can ask me. So this is the concept you have to remember. So these universal gravitational constant, understand this universal gravitational constant G value also we can derive from this. That is what we can say. We can modify the formula now according to that. So how to modify this formula? We can write the formula for G value also. So what is that formula? Anybody can say? So as we know, F is equals to capital G into M1 into M2 divided by R squared. Now I want formula for G. Can anybody say what is the formula for G? Now first I can
equal to F into R square divided by M1 into M2.
F into R square is equals to G into M1 into M2. Yes or no? Now we want G alone. Yes, so product and masses will come this side. It will become what?
Division.
So force into gravitational force of attraction into square of distance between them divided by M1 into M2, which is equals to what? Universal gravitational constant. Please derive this one all. Meeting is going to end. So please, all of you write it. So capital G is equals to what? Capital G is equals to F into
R square divided by M1 into M2.
R you can write like this also. F into D square divided by capital M into small m. Anything is correct.
Small m.
So that is, this is according to our textbook. This is according to us. So you can write it anything. Please write it. Okay.